We learned how to solve a single nonlinear equation using Newton's method, the fastest method. We're now in a position where we can generalize that to a system of nonlinear equations, making use of some of our matrix algebra techniques. So let's just talk about two equations here, though this generalizes to n equations. So we want to solve, say, two nonlinear equations. So I'll write this as f of xy equals 0 and g of xy equals 0. So again, a root-finding method, but instead of one nonlinear equation, we have here two nonlinear equations. So our iteration is going to be a sequence of values, x naught, x1, so on, and y naught, y1, so on, that hopefully will converge to one of the roots of this system of equations. Okay? How do we derive Newton's method for this? We can use Taylor series expansions. So let's say we did n iterations and we're on the n plus 1 iteration. We can write f of x sub n plus 1, y sub n plus 1. And Taylor series expand this function now about x sub n and y sub n. So the first term in the Taylor series will be f of xn, yn. The next term in the Taylor series, using the partial derivative, so this is a Taylor series of a function of two variables. The next term in the Taylor series for an expansion about xn, yn will be xn plus 1 minus xn times the partial derivative of f with respect to x, so I'll use this notation, evaluated at xn, yn, plus the yn plus 1 minus yn times the partial derivative of f with respect to y, evaluated at xn, yn. And then there are higher order terms, but in Newton's method, we only consider the linear approximation to the function. We can do the same thing for g. So we have g of xn plus 1, yn plus 1, and that's equal to then g at xn, yn plus xn plus 1 minus xn, the partial of g with respect to x, of xn, yn, plus yn plus 1 minus yn, the partial of g with respect to y of xn, yn. And then I'm going to drop all of the higher order terms. Okay, we're doing this Taylor series expansion. The goal is to find the value of x and y where f will be 0. So we would like xn plus 1 and yn plus 1 to satisfy f at those values equals 0. So if you remember the Newton's method, this is approximating the function by a straight line and looking for the x-intercept in the single variable case. So now we're setting these two equal to 0. So this gets set equal to 0. And this one gets set equal to 0. I'm going to solve, instead of solving for xn plus 1 and yn plus 1, let's solve for this difference. So we're going to define delta xn equals xn plus 1 minus xn. So that's the change in x. And we're going to find delta yn equals yn plus 1 minus yn. So these terms here become delta, right? This becomes delta xn. This one becomes delta yn and delta xn, delta yn. And then we want to determine delta xn and yn, right? Because if we determine delta xn and yn, then we can use the fact that xn plus 1 then is equal to xn plus delta xn, and yn plus 1 is equal to yn plus delta yn. Okay? Okay, so these are our equations. So these are equations for delta xn and delta yn. We can see what they are. The left-hand side is 0. We have a matrix here. So I can write that as our delta xn, delta yn is a column vector. And the matrix multiplying this is going to be f sub x times delta xn, and it's going to be f sub y times delta yn, and then g sub x times delta xn, and g sub y times delta yn, and then the right hand side is bringing the f and the g to the other side, so it's going to be equal to the negative of f and g. And the matrix elements and the right-hand side are all evaluated at xn, yn, right? So this is at xn, yn. This is at xn, yn. And this is at xn, yn. Okay? So we get then a matrix equation, an iteration equation. So let's see, how does this work? We're trying to solve these two nonlinear functions for the variable x and y, so two coupled nonlinear equations, f of xy equals 0, some general form of x and y, right? So it could be x squared y plus whatever, it could be anything, right? And g of xy equal to 0. We're solving this using Newton's method applied to a system of two nonlinear equations. We're looking for an iteration scheme. So we compute, we start with x naught, y naught as our initial guess. Then we compute x1, y1. Then we compute x2, y2. And we hope that it converges to a root. So provided that we start close enough to a root in our initial guess, it will converge to the closest root. In order to determine what is this iteration scheme, we do a Taylor series expansion of f and g at the xn plus 1, yn plus 1 iteration. This is the Taylor series. And we want xn plus 1 and yn plus 1 to be a good approximation to the root. So the left-hand side becomes 0, and then this becomes an equation for our increment, delta xn and delta yn. So xn plus 1 is xn plus delta xn, yn plus 1 equals yn plus delta yn. The equation is a matrix equation. We need to compute the partial derivatives of this function f and g. With each iteration, we need to update this matrix because we need to compute these partials at the previous iteration at xn and yn. And likewise, we need to compute the right-hand side at the previous iteration, f and g, at the value of xn, yn. Then solving this matrix equation, using Gaussian elimination, of course, we get delta xn and delta yn, and then we update our values in the iteration. Converges very fast because it's Newton's method, and you will have some calculations to do making use of this method. This matrix here has a name. This is called the Jacobian matrix. You also see this matrix in a course on vector calculus. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.